Okay, we're going to go over the basics of factoring. We're going to begin by pulling the greatest common factor out in front of some polynomial. So first of all, I want you to realize that multiplying is kind of the opposite of factoring. There's two ways of writing the same thing. For instance, a factored form of something might be 2 times x plus 5, but if we multiply it out, we would use the distributive property and get 2x plus 10. So on the left is our, usually we call that the simplified form, and on the right, that's the factored form. So far, we've mainly gone from something that is factored and multiplied it out to simplify it. Now we're going to go the other way around. So the question is, how would I start from 2x plus 10 and get the factored form of 2x plus 5? All right, so let's see. If we start with 2x plus 10, what we're looking for is a common factor. Now, one way of doing this is noticing that we have two terms. 2x is a term and 10 is a term. And if we just factor each term, we see they have a common factor of 2 in each term. So in this case, we'd say 2 is the greatest common factor. There's no other larger factor than 2. And what we could do is pull that out to the front. It's like doing the opposite of the distributive property. You're going backwards. You have to think 2 times what will give you 2x, that would be x, plus what would go over here? 2 times what would give you 2 times 5? Well, the 5. And you would check by doing the distributive property and seeing that, yes, 2 times x plus 5 really is the same as 2x plus 10. You wouldn't necessarily need to show that second step. You could simply say 2x plus 10, figure out that 2 is a factor of both 2x and 10. So you write that in front and figure what you're going to have to multiply by to get back to the 2x plus 10, which will be x plus 5. All right, so I want you to try that for this problem. 6x minus 18. Put it on pause and try that. So it's true that 2 goes into both 6 and 18, but we want to pull out the greatest common factor, which is 6. So we'd have 6 times x gives us 6x, and there's a minus sign here. So 6 times what gives you 18? 3. All right. How about another one? 25y plus 35. Try that one. All right, the greatest common factor here is 5, goes from both 25 and 35. And 5 times what will give you 25y? 5y. And then 5 times what will give you 35? 7. And in all of these, really, you should go back and multiply back out to see if you would get exactly the same answer. Okay, now we have one just a little bit more complicated. So what we're trying to do is find what the greatest common factor is. So even though I wouldn't normally do this, I'm going to factor each one of these three terms completely. Remember, terms are separated by the plus or minus sign. So I have 2 times 2 times x, times y, times y, minus 2 times 3, times x, times y, times y, and then I really have a plus 2 times 2, times 2, times x, times y. Now, to be a common factor, it's got to be in all of them, so I'm going to note that there is a 2 in all of them. I'm going to start with the first term and say, well, is there another 2 in all of them? No. Now, I have 2x's here, 2x's here, but 1x here. So they all only have 1x. Now, how many y's do they have in common? Well, I've got 3 y's here. I've got 4 y's here and 2 there. So they all have at least 2 y's. So the greatest common factor ends up being 2 times x. I forgot to put these two. 2x y squared. Notice for the numbers between 4, 6, and 8, 2 is the largest number that goes into all of them. And now when you look at the variables, the one that's got the smallest exponent, that's going to be what you're using for your greatest common factor. So for instance, there's only x to the first power, so that's going to be it for the x's. And then for the y squared also happens to be the smallest exponent, because this is a y cubed and a y squared. So let's go back to this exact same problem again. 4x squared y cubed minus 6x squared y to the fourth plus 8xy squared. And we're going to say, all right, first we're going to look between the numbers. There's a 4, there's a 6, and an 8. 2, that's the largest whole number. It could be that it's just 1, which you wouldn't write that down. All right, now we have an x squared, and an x. X is the one with the smallest exponent. We choose that. We have a y cubed, a y to the fourth, and a y squared. So y squared. That is your greatest common factor that we pull out to the front. And now we have to say, what are we going to multiply that by to get back to the original answer? So 2xy squared times what will give you 4x squared y cubed? Well, you need a 2 to get the 4. You have one factor of x, so you need an x to get the x squared. And you also need a y squared times y to get the y cubed. All right, the next term, 2 times what will give you 6? 3. And x times what will give you x squared? An x. And y squared times what will give you y to the fourth? Y squared. We have a plus. And 2 times what will give you 8? 4. X times, well, I only need one x, so I've got it. I have a y squared. I only need a y squared, so I've already got it. So that's your answer right here. Notice that it's factored because it's written as 2xy squared times something that happens to be in parentheses. We started out with a simplified form, really, and ended up with a factored form. Here's one I want you to try. You want to factor this, and then in your head, check it to make sure if you did the distributive property, you would end up with the original problem. Put it on pause and try that. All right, so let's do that. Between 20 and 10, 10 is the greatest common factor. Between x cubed and x squared, we'd have an x squared. And between y squared and y, we'd have a y. So what would I have to multiply by? 10x squared y times what will give you 20x cubed y squared? Well, I need a 2 to get back to 20. I need an x times x squared to get back to x cubed. I needed a y times a y to end up at y squared. Minus, and here's where people make their mistake, 10x squared y times what will give you the 10x squared y. It's not 0, it's 1. So in other words, the only factor still there, but it's you don't really see it, could be thought of as times 1. That's really there if you want to imagine. Okay, so you do have to remember to put the minus 1. Or if it was a plus sign, it would be plus 1. And the way to make sure you're correct is to multiply it back out using the distributive property and see if you get back to the original problem. Also, to make sure you pulled out the greatest common factor, see what's left in the parentheses and make sure there's no common factors. So 2xy and 1, no other common factors you could pull out. Okay, here's another one I want you to try. 12x squared plus 18xy squared. All right, what I'm going to do is say, what if you thought that 2 was the greatest common factor, or maybe 2x? Let's pick out 2x. That would give me 6x to get back to 12x squared. And let's see, 2x, 2 times 9 is 18. I already have the x, y squared. Now, it's true that if I did the distributive property, I get 12x squared plus 18xy squared But if you look what's left inside the parentheses, you have a 6 and a 9. There's another greatest common factor there of 3. So you did not pull out the greatest common factor. You can do it now, but it's a lot more work. You would say, okay, I'm going to pull out a 3 times 2x plus 3y squared. And then the 2x times 3 is 6x. 2x plus 3y squared. Let's do the distributive property again. You see that you do get the correct answer. But it would have been faster to notice that you could pull out 6x to begin with and get 2x plus 3y squared. So always look for the greatest common factor. Math is cool and you can